beautiful souls, and welcome to our full moon ritual, our final full moon of 2022, full moon in Gemini. Some things before we get started, you might want to bring a warm beverage, maybe some tea. I have some cacao. Definitely grab a glass of water. Grab your notebook, grab a pen, maybe burn some incense or sage, something to kind of allow you to be more in your senses, like ground you in this present moment. And also grab a blanket and a pillow, just in case. So, this is a full moon, the last full moon of 2022. So naturally, we'll be feeling energetically the frequency of kind of like tying up all the loose ends. So we can step into 2023 with a blank space. And Gemini, qualities of Gemini are very intellectual and witty, naturally curious. And so how I interpret this full moon period is a time to release any thoughts or belief systems that you don't think are serving you anymore. Any thoughts or belief systems that don't create good feeling emotions in your body. You have full permission to let it go. And we're gonna practice that during this flow today. Just notice as you're going through your asana practice, what comes up in your mind? Is it serving you? Does it feel good to think these thoughts? Have you thought these thoughts over and over again to form a belief about yourself or the way that you see the world? You are safe to fully and completely let it go. And if you want to pick it back up, you're like, wait, I want to keep thinking those things that don't feel good for whatever reason. You can pick it up later, no problem. Just try it on. See how it feels to become the person that maybe doesn't think that way. What version of you, right? What version of you would not be thinking that thought? You know the one. So we'll start settling in to our practice with the intention to let go, to soften into the present moment. And depending where you are in your day, might have just walked through hell and back. It's okay. Might be hard to kind of leave your bags at the door, right? But they're heavy. It's heavy. And you don't have to think about it right now, at least. Give yourself this freedom and this permission to come into your body, come into your breath. Connect with the breath. If you're starting to spiral like me, just kind of feel the energies in your heart space. Not changing anything or doing anything different, except for observing how it feels. Area of your heart. It's gonna be nice and sweet and slow. Just bringing you back to that stillness, that center point that eternally exists within you. Maybe go ahead and switch to spiral in the opposite direction. Being with your body, being with your breath, and observing whatever comes into your mind. Not judging or labeling or continuing the thought pattern, just notice and let it go. If you want to label it, just call it a thought. It's a thought. Okay. Back to the breath. Back to the body. Back to the present moment. Let's come down through center, placing your hands on your knees and just swaying side to side, just doing whatever feels right. Kind of lifting up and out of your torso and grounding through your sits bones, through your root chakra, muladhara. Side to side, exploring the boundaries of your body, not pushing past your limitations, you know, just feeling. My squid smiles are so cute. They're all smiling at me. Down through prayer. Big breath in. Big breath out. Remind yourself of your intention to let go. It's okay to let go. Breathe in all that you are, knowing that you don't need to hold on to these stories anymore. Breathe up and out. Exhale, hands come down. My big breath, inhale, arms rise up. Exhale, hands come down, 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 back, third breath. Maybe bowing your head to your heart if that feels right for you. Just as an acknowledgement and appreciation for yourself, to yourself, for showing up right here and right now. You're here, you've made it. The hardest part has arrived and passed through. Don't need to worry anymore. You're doing everything you need to be doing. You've done everything you could possibly do. Now it's time to let go and trust. 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 Even if maybe things aren't working out the way you thought they would, let that go. Let that go. Let that go. There is a higher purpose. Higher purpose to your pain and your suffering. There is a higher purpose to your path. So if things aren't working out the way you thought they would, lean back into trust. Do some cat-cows as you lean back and exhale. Know that you are supported by something much, much bigger than you, than I, than us. It's bigger than we can imagine. It's infinite. And this infinite support that we have is also part of us. Breathe into that space. Beautiful. We'll come back through center. Just open up our neck a little bit. Inhaling as your chin lifts up, and exhaling as you come down. Switch opposite direction. Go ahead, shrug your shoulders all the way up. And back, exhale, down, inhale. And exhale, inhale, squeeze at the top. And again, we'll inhale, rise up, and exhale, hands up and down, 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 all the way down. Good job so far. Together, let's meet, I don't know what this is called, mermaid pose. This is a mermaid. Let's just meet here. So like one leg is back, and the foot is like touching your thigh. And your feet can be flexed. I guess let's say the back leg can be at like 90 degrees. And then you're just gonna lean back, kind of like windshield wiper. That was my foot, Sylvie. Obviously. You're just gonna windshield wiper your legs side to side. Opening up your hips. Massaging your tailbone. Awesome. And I'm kind of like scooch your way down. Gonna move my look out of the way. Scooch your way down. So you're on your elbow. And then just, straighten your front, your top leg, and just like stretch it all the way out. Your back leg could be bent. And I know it's like a little unconventional, but just breathe here for a minute. Breathing in and breathing out. Breathe in and breathe out. One more big breath, inhale, and exhale. Beautiful. Slowly, slowly, slowly come back. And then we're just going to switch very simply onto the other side. And then take that top leg and come closer. And then just straighten it out. Feels so good in your spine. Just breathe, inhale, and exhale. Two more breaths here, inhale, and exhale. One more nice big breath in, and big breath out. On your next breath, slowly come back. This way, and just lower onto your back. Windshield wiping your leg side to side. Just like gonna loosen up our spine a little bit. Continuing to twist. Getting those nice, not pushing yourself too far. Notice your body and its limitations, and honor your limitations. You know, breathe into a state of acceptance, trust, be with yourself, breathe with yourself. Awesome. And then we'll come back through center, placing the soles of your feet on your mat. And then go ahead and kind of like squeeze your abs in a little bit. Place your hands on the ground. Squeeze your core and then lift yourself up. So we're just in like a nice little bridge here. And this is getting a nice deep stretch in your thighs, your hips, your belly, even your heart. And see if you can kind of like release your glutes a little bit so that you're not squeezing them really tight. It's just like kind of just hanging out, right? Holding yourself up by the strength of your legs and building that nice strong foundation that carries your entire body through this time and space. Breathe in and breathe out. Each breath out, you release and let go what's no longer serving you in this present moment. And maybe something's been weighing on your mind specifically. Like, I don't want to be this person anymore. Lower down. Bring your feet together, like your knees together. Just kind of like circle out your hips a little bit. And so maybe you're like, I don't want to be this, the person who does this. Choose to let it go. You can let it go right here, right now, and practice being a different person who has different beliefs. And go ahead, switch. So you're going inside now, inside. So yeah, maybe we can't control what's going on outside of us. Maybe our thoughts seem a little out of our control too. They're just conditioning. It's just conditioning, right? Bring your feet together and then slowly come down into Supta Baddha Konasana. Yeah, recline bound ankle pose. You can put your hands on your belly and breathe. Know that your thoughts, yeah, they sound very real, I know. But it's just conditioning, just showing us what we have learned to believe. As you breathe, feel your belly rise with each inhale. And fall with each exhale. Maybe activating that ujjayi breath. A deep yogic breath in through your nose and out your nose, your throat nice and constricted. Slowly, 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 and rotating your wrist, inviting movement to your body, and bringing your knees in towards your chest, and you give yourself a nice big hug. Go ahead, roll onto the left side of your body, coming up onto your belly. On your belly. So you're just gonna lay here and your hands are flat and your elbows are underneath your shoulders. And then you're just gonna like pull your heart open. Feel that nice deep stretch in your belly. And if it's like too much on your low back, right? If you're feeling like too much pressure, You can just come out of it and come into a child's pose like this. This actually feels really nice. I'm gonna come back here and just breathe into this just for a few breaths. Breathing into all that you desire to be, the person you desire to become, and aligning your thoughts, your vision, your beliefs, your perceptions with that person. Each and every moment, each and every breath. Wherever you are, slowly push your way back up to all fours. We'll meet in the middle. And then tuck your toes. Go ahead, push back into your palms. Hips come up, downward facing dog. Pedaling out your feet here. Just doing whatever feels good for you right now. Maybe that's a little twist, a little shaking the head out, a little back and forth, whatever feels good. Maybe some stillness. Breathe it in. Let it go. Breathe it in. Let it go. One more time, breathe it in. Let it go. Beautiful. Go ahead, walk your feet up to your hands. Spine straight and flat back. And exhale, forward fold. Really release the back of your neck here. Kind of like tuck your chin in towards your chest. Shake your head no. And shake your head yes. Maybe make one circle. And a circle in the opposite direction. And on your next inhale, go ahead, straighten your arms up behind your back. And exhale, clasp your hands, opening up your heart. One big breath here, inhale. Exhale, slowly release, let it go, let it go, let it go, let it go. Sinking your hips down, 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 down. And then just coming forwards. Feet are nice and flexed out. So lots of activity, action, lots of energy coming out your legs. Like pushing, not like pushing like so far. See how high my heels are? Just a little bit, right? They're not like lacy, but not like, oh my God, push, push, you know? Find like a happy medium. And we'll inhale, shimmy your shoulders out a little bit, maybe some spirit fingers. Just find some energy, something cultivating inside you. Breathe it in, lift your chin up. Exhale, come down, 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 forward fold. Inhale, big breath. And exhale, release. Inhale, big breath. And exhale, release. And keep breathing in. And keep breathing out. Bringing back to mind that person, that being that you are dreaming of embodying. Allow this vision of yourself to clarify with your intuition. Use the power of your mind to visualize what would this person, maybe it's your higher self, what are they like? What qualities do they embody? And what are you going to have to let go of in order to fully merge with this being? Allow yourself to come closer to yourself with each inhale. And with each exhale, release and let go everything that you need to in order to evolve. Shoulders all the way up to your ears. And exhale. Release out. And slowly, slowly, slowly come to your back. This time we're going to take our right leg and just cross it over our left thigh. Go ahead, clasp your hands behind your left thigh as you inhale. And then exhale, go ahead, pull that left leg close into your body. Making sure your right foot is nice and flexed. Breathe, inhale, exhale, be with your body, be with your breath. Slowly, slowly, slowly release your grip. Bring your left leg down. Keep your right leg where it is. And just shift your hips over so your right leg comes down, down, down. And back into nice deep twist. Letting go, letting go, letting go. Be with your body and be with your breath. Now squeeze your core and cross your legs. Go ahead, shift your hips back through center. This time left leg comes up, crosses over your right. Then go ahead, clasp your hands behind that right thigh. Exhale, pull that leg in towards your chest. Slowly, slowly, slowly release the grip behind your legs, bringing your right foot back down. Then go ahead and shift your hips over to the left and allow your knees to gently fall on over to the right side. Gaze is over your left shoulder as you drop into your body through the portal of your breath. Seeing if you can consciously let go with each breath out. Releasing and letting go. next breath in, slowly bring everything back through center. And shifting your hips up and over and crossing your legs. And just go ahead and windshield wiper your knees side to side. Slowly re-center your spine and kind of like wiggle your tailbone into the mat. Feel grounded as you lift your feet up and just take a couple of breaths here. And if you have any final movements that your body is craving today, please go ahead and take them now. Make them now. Do them, flow through them. Or if you want to just come on down into Shavasana, definitely feel free to do that. I'm going to try and grab and you can definitely feel free to cover yourself with a blanket, especially your heart. Bring your heels out to the corner of your mat. And tuck your shoulder blades underneath your torso. Really settling in. Settling in, settling down. Releasing the need to control your breath, control your body, control your mind. Using this as a moment to be with yourself. Observe the patterns of your breath. How it feels to be alive, a living and breathing human. How it feels to be you, in your one-of-a-kind, unique human body. Breathe it all in, and let it all go. usually when we hear those thoughts, those future thoughts, or maybe even worries in our mind, it's always kind of like a worst case scenario, maybe. Or a thought that you would be thinking if things didn't work out. And it's okay if you notice yourself thinking that. You don't have to beat yourself up. But just try and like think of the other alternative. Like, what if things actually did work out? What would you be thinking then? And what's the opposite even of your thought right now? And try and override it. Just literally override it. If it hasn't happened yet, see if you can just override those fearful future thoughts with something different. Something more in your favor. And then think that thought again. Try and cancel it out. For every time you think a thought that doesn't serve you, try and think the opposite of that thought 4 times. Maybe if you like social media, picture yourself making an Instagram story about the positive future potential thought. Or sharing a lesson learned about the person you had to become in order to receive what you truly desire. If you haven't already, start deepening your breath and inviting some movement into your body. Breathing nice and deep into your belly, rotating your wrists and your ankles whenever you're ready, rolling onto whatever side of your body feels right for you in this present moment. Breathing and being here. Your body and your breath. And just bringing to mind the intentions that we set in the beginning of our practice. Slowly, slowly, slowly. Begin using your hands, kind of like, push your way back up. Pressing your way back up to a nice, comfortable seat. Taking a few breaths here into your heart. Allowing yourself to show up for yourself, for your heart's pure desires. Together, let's rise. Arms up, all the way up. And exhale, hands come down, down, down through prayer. Watching over your aura. Place your palms on the ground, on your mat, to send some loving, healing vibes to Mama Earth, to Goddess Gaia, for allowing us to experience life as a human. What a strange, unique gift that is. We'll take one more big breath in. Arms lift up overhead. Gather all that energy, everything we've worked through together in class today. Exhale, hands come down, watching over your aura, and placing your palms on your heart to give love and healing vibes to yourself, thanking yourself for showing up for your practice today. Thank you so much for being here, and thank you for being you. Sending you so much love and blessings your way. And namaste. Namaste, yogis. Happy, happy, happy full moon. Make sure to drink some water. Water. Cheers. Happy last moon of 2022. Last full moon of 2022. Just igniting our water with all that good energy that we cultivated during our asana practice today, and allowing the energy to infuse our water with these intentions of stepping into the person we dream of embodying, and allowing ourselves to gracefully, thoughtfully, intentionally, with ease and flow, let go of anything that is not aligned with our higher self, a beautiful being. So, I'd love to know what you gained from this practice. Any insights you feel guided to share, please let me know in the comments below. I would love to know anything that came up for you during this practice. It would be so cool just to like hear some other perspectives of the collective energies that's kind of going through us right now. If you want to stay for our journaling practice, you are so more than welcome. Ooh. It just turned on. Yay. You are absolutely welcome to stay. And if you have any questions too, you know, maybe something came up that was like unfamiliar, I'm also very much here to answer those questions. But otherwise, you can grab your notebook, start on a clean page. And I always like to, on my full moon and new moon practices, I like to just write the date and like full moon in, we're in Gemini, so this is a full moon in Gemini at 16 degrees. The 16 degrees is like kind of, if you're into astrology, it tells you which house this full moon is landing in when you compare it to 16 degrees Gemini on your natal chart. So Gemini is all about intellect. It's very like multi-passionate. Like Gemini's energies are very like I like this and I like this and I like this, and they're all kind of different, but it like brings like the Gemini energy of the individual kind of like brings it all together. Gemini is also about commitment, luck, what else? Fast learning and curiosity. So yeah, lots of like in the head, in the mind. And some like negative or just like some hindrances of Gemini's qualities are indecision, impulsiveness, sometimes a little unreliability, nosiness, but they're also very perceptive and analytical, right, in the mind. So use those words to kind of guide you through the stream of consciousness and journaling practice. Anything that maybe comes up within you on, you know, those traits of being analytical, being curious, being perceptive, maybe a little impulsive, and how it relates to your life in this present moment. Is there anything that's kind of like come to a point where you're like, oh yeah, well maybe I wouldn't be here if I didn't make that impulsive decision, or if I took more time to, you know, if I took more time to like really hone in on like my direction and where I want to go, or you know, maybe I spent more time developing certain skills, you know, that could help assist you in a job or career, different avenue of your life. If anything's, whatever is feeling right and resonant for you, just like allow yourself to really just, if you can't think of like how to start, just start by writing that. I don't know how to start this. There's no wrong way to do stream of consciousness journaling. And just lean back into trust. Like whatever's gonna come out is what comes out. And if you've never done like a stream of consciousness journal practice before, then yay, congratulations. Like this is, you're trying something new, and that is so beautiful and something to be commended. So no pressure, just let yourself go into the Gemini energy and focusing on things to let go. The full moon is like a time to really release and just let it all go. So maybe you've been, you know, too indecisive. What have you been indecisive about? And what can you let go to become more decisive? Just some ideas, but go ahead. Go ahead and let yourself go. always come back to it in the morning. Thank you so much for taking the time to anchor in these frequencies and to cultivate a deeper awareness of the self. As we continue to grow and evolve on this journey of evolution, we inspire others to do the same. We consciously and unconsciously allow others to grow and evolve with us. And that is what we are doing here on Earth. Kind of crazy, kind of cool, kind of weird. Thank you for everything. And like I said, if you want to leave any insights, definitely comment below and let me know how you're feeling, what you're thinking, who you're becoming. I want to cheer you on and celebrate every single step of the way. Thank you so much for being here. Thank you for being you. Blessings and goodbye.